Recently, I conducted a poll on my Instagram where I asked you two questions. Number one, how often do you revise your material? And number two, how do you revise your material? The purpose of this was to analyze your study techniques and then give you some study techniques that are backed up by science and research. Hey there, I'm Subhav Ramnani, the guy who's mad about medicine just like you. If you're new here, make sure to subscribe to the channel by clicking the button below and also follow me on Instagram where I post some amazing medical content, interesting quizzes and some exciting challenges and giveaways. You can find the links to all of this and everything else mentioned in this video down in the description box below. So let's go. All of the things I'm going to talk to you about today are backed up by research conducted on students like you and me. I'll put down a link for these researches if you wish to read further. So as you can see, most of you answered that you revise on days when you don't study any new material. And rereading was the most popular way of revision. So while rereading, making notes and highlighting are amongst the most popular, research says they are actually not very effective and they provide a very low yield for the hard work you put in. Methods that make you retrieve information out of your brain are the ones that actually strengthen the connections in your memory. This is called active recall or active retrieval. So today, we are going to go through 5 of these active retrieval or active recall methods, and in the end, we will summarize them in a tabular form so you can see which one fits best for you. Number 1, recall with the book closed. Now, since most of you answered rereading, it's wise to start with this topic. Recalling with the book closed means keeping the book in front of you and just recalling the information about the topic you studied. Now, whatever you can't remember, just jot down the topic name down on a piece of paper. Only once you are done recalling all the information, you can have a look at the book and go ahead and see what all you missed. After this, close the book again and recall all the material with the missed points. So those of you who just cannot live without taking notes, this one is for you. After you study a topic, take a piece of paper and make a spider map of all the information you learned. Again, this has to be without looking at the book or the resource you are using. So this will be your first pass through the material. When it comes to revising this, you will essentially look at the center of your spider map and hide the other things. From here, try to actively recall all the information of the map you made. You do this every time you revise. Number 3, Feynman technique. Now you might remember this technique from my first YouTube video, which tells you why I started mad about medicine. Now Feynman technique is by Richard Feynman, an American Nobel Prize winning physicist. Now this technique tells you to pick a topic and study it with an idea to explain it to a child or someone who does not already know about it. When you go through this process of teaching someone, you actually recall all the information actively. Once done, you analyze if there were any gaps in your teaching and then you head back to the resources to fill in those gaps. Number 4, flashcards. Now this is a method I personally use every single day and have loved it ever since. A classic flashcard is basically a paper card which has a question or a hint on the front of it and an answer written on the back of it. However, you are not limited just by this. You can make digital flashcards with the help of Anki. Anki is a platform which involves active recall and spaced repetition in its algorithm. I already have a video on it and I'll link it in the top right corner here and also in the description box below if you would like to know more about it. Number 5, taking tests and doing questions. Now taking tests and doing questions has several benefits. Not only it helps you to practice the pattern of the exam and know the important stuff, but it is also a way which forces you to recall information without looking at the resource. A study conducted on students stated that students who took a practice test before an exam tend to perform 15 to 30% better than the students who didn't take a practice test. Now you know why people say to take grand tests and other tests regularly if you are preparing for a board level exam like the NEET PG or the USMLE. So now all of these five techniques give you the benefit of active recall or active retrieval. Now let's compare them with each other and you can see which one fits best for you. So while recalling with the book closed is the easiest to implement, but it also makes you fall into procrastination quickly. The quickest method would be the flashcards, while Feynman techniques usually eats up most of your time, but also providing you with the most deep knowledge. Flashcards are the best method for memorization by far, but you often tend to lose the bigger picture. And here is where SpiderMap can help you out. At last, taking tests should be mandatory in any study plan in my opinion, as the pros weigh out the cons by a margin. I'll attach this summary table in the description box below if you would like to read through all of it. Comment down below what study method you like the best and you would use. Hopefully, you can master these techniques and retain as much information as you can and then ace your exams. Now, about the challenge. So this new challenge will be based on these study techniques and I'll post all the details about the challenge on my Instagram page, Mad About Medicine. I'll put the links down in the description box below. As always, stay healthy, stay safe, and stay mad, but just about medicine.